Today, we're going to talk about the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or the CVSS, version 2 and version 3. You might just be the smartest person in the room after today's lesson. We're going to start off here in Tenable, and I'm going to go to the critical vulnerabilities because in this exercise, we're going to take these vulnerabilities and I'm going to teach you the Common Vulnerability Scoring System metrics, and then we're going to walk through scoring these vulnerabilities, and you're going to understand exactly what these metrics means after this video. I'm going to start with the first one, .NET Core, and I'm going to go to where it says right here. I'm going to zoom in for you. Now, I want you to pay particular attention to this right here, the CVSS vector. This is what we're going to learn today, the CVSS vector, CVSS V2 and CVSS V3 vectors. Right now, this doesn't mean anything, but in a couple of seconds, this is going to be very clear exactly what this is. To get started with this, I want you to visit the Technology Interpreters website because I've already got these linked here for you. In the top right-hand corner, you see Cybersecurity Resources. Click on Cybersecurity Resources. At the bottom of the list, under Vulnerability Management, you see the CVSS V2 and V3 calculators. Click on the V2 calculator and then go back and click on the V3 calculator. Now, going back to Tenable, let's start with the first part of the CVSS V3 vector. Notice this says AVN. And each one is separated by a forward slash, the little line that's leaning to the right, okay? So forward slash and backslash. Forward slash leans to the right, backslash leans to the left. Now, if you notice in the CVSS V3 calculator, it says AV. So AV, attack vector, comparing that to Tenable, AV, and then the colon, and then it's what the actual value is. So AV colon N. When I go back to the calculator, attack vector and network. So that tells us this vulnerability is a network-based attack. Let's go to the next metric. ACL. AC stands for attack complexity. L is low. The complexity of this attack is low. PRN. PR stands for privilege required and no privileges are required. N. UIN. UI stands for user interaction and none is required. N. If it were R, that was what would mean that user interaction is required. SC. SC is for, first of all, S is for scope and C is for change. S colon C, S colon C. C colon H. C stands for confidentiality colon H. Hi. So the impact to confidentiality. And if you know the CIA triad, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. So C. The impact to confidentiality is high. The I colon H, integrity, I, the impact to integrity is high, H, I colon H, A colon H, availability, A, high, A colon H. So by using the CVSS calculator, we just decoded the CVSS attack vector so we understand exactly how people can attack us using it to exploit this vulnerability. So a network attack, once again, that has low complexity, that's privilege required is none, user interaction none, scope has changed, confidentiality impact high, integrity impact high, availability impact high. Let's move on to CVSS V2. I'm now in the CVSS V2 calculator. It's a little bit different. The metrics are a little different. And so let's go through the same attack or the same vulnerability using the CVSS V2 metrics. If you notice right here in Tenable, the CVSS vector is here. So AV colon N, AV access vector colon N, network AV colon N, AC colon L, AC access complexity, L low, AC colon L. And you can see the access complexities are broken down into high, medium, and low. AU colon N, AU stands for authentication. And no authentication or none is required. The choices are multiple and single. If you hover over each one in the calculator, it gives you a description of each of these. C colon C, confidentiality impact, C. C, complete. So this vulnerability completely impacts confidentiality. I colon C, you should know the pattern now. Integrity, complete, I colon C. The impact on integrity is complete impact. There is a total compromise of the system integrity. There's a complete loss of system protection, resulting in an entire system being compromised. The attacker has the ability, is able to modify any file on the target system. I:C, integrity impact. A:C, you figured it out by now. Availability impact. A:C, complete. A:C, choices are partial and none. Okay, so we've now analyzed this one. So let's do a live exercise here. Let's walk through this together. I'm going to present this, and I want you to take a few moments, and I want you to analyze this attack. I'll give you a couple of seconds to get ahead of me, and then I'm going to read through this. And if I were you, I would try to read through this without looking at the guy, without looking at the calculator, because this is pretty easy to remember, but we can always reference it. So AV, CVSS V3, attack vector, right? And I think the trickiest thing to note is some of the terminology used. Access vector, attack vector. Okay, CVSS V3, attack vector, attack complexity. CVSS V2, access vector, access access complexity. CVSS V3, privileges required. CVSS V2, authentication. Okay, so you can kind of see the difference here. So let's go ahead and take a shot at this. Okay, so access, this is CVSS V3, attack vector, network. What's our next one? If we go to 3, attack complexity, AC. Low, privileges required, none. User interaction, :R. What does that R stand for? User interaction is required. That's what we talked about before. SU, scope, unchanged. C, confidentiality impact, high. Integrity impact, high. Availability impact, high. Okay, are you starting to get it? All right, now let's look at the CVSS V2 right here. Access, AV, access vector, network, access complexity, low. Let's double check our work here. AC, access vector, network, access complexity, low. All right, so that's pretty good. AU, authentication, none. All right, confidentiality impact, and let's look at this. This is confidentiality impact. There it is right quick. Complete, integrity impact, complete, availability impact, complete. Don't forget to check out my other video. I'm doing a complete Tenable 2025 series that's going through teaching you vulnerability management. So if you are somebody that's trying to change jobs to get into cybersecurity, maybe you're in your 30s, late 30s, 40s, 50s, or older, and you're trying to get into cybersecurity, I'm giving you the tools you need, because I am actually, instead of teaching you some generic cybersecurity, this is a tool, Tenable. If you've never heard of this, this is one of the number one tools in the world, or the number one tool for vulnerability assessment. This is what most major Fortune companies are using, okay? So I'm showing you this tool. But the thing is, if you really want to learn this, consider joining the Cybersecurity Mentorship Program. I have a link in the description. I'm actually teaching people one-on-one, working with you individually and in group settings to go through and to fast track your journey into cybersecurity. So if that's interesting to you, then the link below, join the Cybersecurity Mentorship Program. You can subscribe, it's monthly. You can always cancel at any time, but this will help you to get a career, help you to speed up your process. Can't guarantee anybody a job, but once again, it's worth investing in your future. And once again, there's no risk because you can always cancel at any time. So I want to hear from you in the comments. Is this something that you knew about already? And also let me know if you have any other questions, if you want me to dig deeper into this, other metrics within the vulnerability management. But I've got a complete Tenable 2025 series, Tenable Vulnerability Management 2025, that I'm releasing. I'm constantly pumping out videos on it. So please, I'm going to put that up on the screen in just for a second. Check it out. Go to that playlist. Go through that. I've also got endpoint detection using SentinelOne, one of the top tools in the world learned by corporate professionals. You typically can't buy this, but I'm showing you what it is. And if you need access to it, I have a mentorship program where I am mentoring people one-on-one and in group settings to teach you these tools to fast track your journey to get a job in cybersecurity. If this is of interest, check out the link in the description for the Cybersecurity Mentorship Program.